This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, today's topic is neonatal seizures, not neonatal convulsions. What is neonatal seizure? Someone of you volunteer and say, what is a seizure? First of all, what is a seizure? Hello, someone of you speak out, man. Evaro okaru volunteer cheyandi amma, cheppandi. What is a seizure? Whatever you know, exact definition avasaram ledhu. Say something about seizure.
Sir, sudden uncontrolled movements.
Okay, sudden uncontrolled movements. Oh. So, okay, it is okay, little correlating, but not exact. Someone of you can volunteer.
Electrical disturbances.
Okay, somewhat right. Electrical disturbances where?
Brain.
In the brain. Okay, to some extent it is correct. Okay, is it normal or abnormal?
Abnormal.
Okay, so abnormal. Is it paroxysmal or gradual? Paroxysmal means what? Paroxysmal means what?
Unpredictable.
Paroxysmal means?
Sudden or.
Yes, it is sudden. Is it synchronized or asynchronous?
Asynchronous.
Is it synchronous or asynchronous? So, seizure definition, all this together, what is the definition of seizure is, it is an abnormal electrical activity in the brain, which is sudden in onset, that is paroxysmal. Okay, synchronized discharge. Okay, discharges from the neurons in the brain. What is convulsion then? What is seizure? You have told the definition. What is convulsion?
Accompanied by muscular movements, irregular movements.
Yeah. If it is only an electrical activity in the brain and it is abnormal and sudden synchronous discharge, it is called as seizure. If it is associated with musculoskeletal movements, because anyhow CNS is integrated with muscular system, so if there is abnormal movements occurring in the body parts associated with seizure, it is called as convulsion. Speak out loud, yaar. No one is going to give marks. Okay, your friends also will not feel anything, because those who are not speaking don't know anything. Those who are speaking, let at least you are trying to say something. Don't feel about others, don't think about others who doesn't volunteer. Okay, so good. Convulsion means it is an external manifestation of a seizure. Okay, can there be something called non-convulsive seizure?
Absent seizures.
No, absent seizure is a true, but it is a different variety of seizure. I am asking, can there be a seizure without, I am not asking example or anything. Can there be a seizure activity without convulsion? Seizure activity means abnormal electrical activity in the brain. Can it be there without convulsion? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is called as non-convulsive seizure. Okay? it is not associated with any convulsion. Okay, good. So it is seizure, and this is the difference between a seizure and convulsion. Okay, so what is the why is neonatal seizures important? Why do you think neonatal seizures are different? Are they same? Neonatal seizures are the same as adults or older children seizures in older children, or they are slightly different? Do you think? Say something. Do you think it is the same or slightly different?
Different.
In what way do you think they are different? And in what way do you think they are? Is the neonatal brain mature or immature? Please speak out here, otherwise it is very difficult to take a class if you are not involuntary.
Immature, like
mature brain.
Immature brain.
Immature brain. What is mature brain?
Blood brain barrier.
So okay, blood brain barrier, these all are there, but mainly maturation means completion of what is called myelination of all the cortical neurons. Understood? So complete brain development will occur by what year of age? What age? ~90% of the brain development is completed by 2 years of age, and 100% is completed by what year of age? Guess something, no? Some number, at least guess some number. Maybe you are right or wrong. Guess some number.
Hi.
Guess some number, amma. Number guess cheyadaniki kuda. Hello. Hello. It is completed by 73. If you respond, I will give you attendance. Otherwise, I will keep absent. No matter you come to online class or not, I can always speak to principal, sir. Okay, 73 is absent.
31.
What is your name?
Jyoti Prakash.
What is your name?
Jyoti Prakash.
CR. Okay. Jyoti Prakash, class representative. Hello. What is your what by what time or what age brain maturity is completed?
Twenty-five years,
sir. It's too much, no? 25 years, sir.
Five years.
Okay. What else? Some other answer you are saying.
5 years.
Oh, 5 years. Okay. Two answers you have said. Someone else? Roll number 50. Also, 73 is absent anyhow. Don't keep any attendance in the box also. At least now you can speak. 73. Hour, amma. 94 94 94. Absent. 73 94. Okay. 24. 24 24. See, fifth class or sixth class students are much better than you people. You are more right, more of dumb. Okay, I don't know whether you are deaf or deaf also, but no one can change you. You can't become some professionals unless you are having some attitude of interaction with your teacher or senior. Okay, it is of no use. Okay, this is all going under recording. Let the principals are see, but there is no use speaking to you people. Okay, I can read out my slides and I can happily leave. Why to speak to you? Waste of time. Yes. So if you take the definition of seizure, it is a stereotyping. Stereotyping means it occurs repeatedly in the same manner, paroxysmal, which is sudden and abnormal. Okay, altered neurological function. Maybe it is behavioral or motor and or autonomic function. Okay, in the three categories, any of these things has is abnormal, we'll call it as abnormal or altered neurological function. In the neonatal period, which is limited to first 28 days of life for a term baby. Means after 37 weeks of gestation life, we will call it as term infant. Okay, for a preterm, it is up to 44 weeks of postmenstrual age or gestation age. Okay, so seizure is the first sign of neurological dysfunction. Powerful predictors of long-term cognitive and developmental impairment. If a child is or a newborn is having repeated seizures in the neonatal period, seizure is always damaging to the brain because activity get discharged from the electrical focus. Wherever that focus is there, it will damage the surrounding neurons. Okay, so that the cognitive and developmental impairment will occur in the subsequent years. So what is the frequency which it occurs? Incidence of seizures is higher in neonatal period than in other age group because the neonatal brain is immature and myelination is not occurred. So myelination is a protective lipid covering. Okay, lipid covering the neurons. If this is absent or less, there will be chances of increased frequency of seizures. Okay, whatever it is, the etiology, whatever is the cause, the incidence of seizures is higher in neonatal period due to this reason, maturity of the CNS. Why do neonatal seizures have such unusual presentation? Just now I have said, immature CNS cannot sustain a synchronized, well orchestrated generalized seizure. Okay. Immature CNS cannot sustain all these things. So that's why there is a chance of seizure always. Epidemiology means in what race? No race is immune to neonatal seizures. In any race, Caucasian race or Indians, we Indians, Asians, everyone is susceptible. Sex, no male or female gender differences were there. Age, usually we have discussed in the neonatal period, it is the first 4 weeks of life is very important because they are prone for multiple seizures due to various etiology, most frequent during the first, in this first 4 weeks also, that is first 28 days also, 50% of the seizures may occur in the first 10 days of life. Classify neonatal seizures. There are four types of clinical seizures. Okay, sudden seizure, tonic seizure, clonic seizure, and myoclonic seizure. Okay. Encephalographic seizure. Electroencephalographic seizure is could be epileptic or non-epileptic seizure. Okay. So what is subtle seizure? Subtle seizure means it is not exactly a seizure phenomenon. There are some small repetitive movements of some upper or lower limbs, or some eye deviation, or blinking or staring look, repetitive mouth or chewing movements, paddling movements of lower limbs, or tonic posturing of upper limbs, small tonic posturing, boxing jabs means it look, baby looks like some boxing, doing boxing, and all these things are called subtle seizures. It is more, it is the most common type. 50% of the times, the seizures are subtle seizures. Subtle means it is not completely a form of seizure convulsion. It is a subtle form. So most common type and more common in preterm than in term infants. Okay. So they are like eye deviation in term, blinking or fixed staring look for prolonged period in preterm, repetitive mouth and tongue chewing movements, okay, or tongue thrusting movements, apnea means cessation of respiration for about 10 to 20 seconds, paddling or tonic posturing of limbs, all this comes under subtle seizures. What is a tonic seizure? Tonic seizure is focal or generalized. Okay. It is seen primarily in a preterm infant. Sustained periods of muscle contraction. Sustained extension of the upper and lower limbs. Okay. Sustained periods of muscle contraction is called tonic. Clonic means movement, a fast contraction phase followed by slow relaxation phase is called as clonic. So tonic means sustained periods of muscle contraction. Sustained extension of it mimics sustained extension of upper and lower limbs. It mimics decelebrate posturing. Sustained flexion of upper with extension of lower limb mimics decorticate posturing. Okay. So signals severe intracranial hemorrhage in preterm infants. Tonic posturing signals severe intracranial hemorrhage in preterm infants. Generally poor prognosis if tonic seizures occurs in a newborn. Okay. Clonic seizure primarily in term. Focal or multifocal. Okay, clonic seizures primarily occurs in term, whereas subtle and tonic seizures are more common in preterm infants. Subtle seizures can occur in term also, but clonic is primarily in a term infant. Okay, so it can be focal or multifocal. Focal clonic, multifocal clonic. Biphasic. Biphasic means fast contraction phase followed by slow relaxation phase. Clonic limb movements, synchronous or asynchronous, localized or often with anatomic order of progression, means from one part of the body to other part of the body. It is called as Jacksonian march. CR, have you heard of Jacksonian march? Jyoti Prakash?
No, sir.
So read of Jacksonian march. Jacksonian march is from one part of the body, if the convulsion is going to different parts of the body in a anatomically order of progression, it is called as Jacksonian march. So clonic limb movements, consciousness may be preserved because it is not very much a serious condition in a newborn. So prognosis is consciousness is also preserved. Okay, signals. Focal cerebral injury. Some focal cerebral injury leads to this clonic seizures. Okay, clonic seizures have good prognosis. myoclonic seizures. So myoclonic is rare, focal, multifocal clonic or generalized clonic. So myoclonic. So myoclonic, myoclonus means lightning fast contractions, very fast contractions with a rapid rate, like jerks. If you say jerks in upper limbs, slightly like jerks, it is called as jerk myoclonus. Okay. Myoclonus in a newborn is very, very poor prognosis because it usually associated with serious subsequent poor neurodevelopmental outcome. Okay, myoclonic seizures in a newborn is actually dangerous. So what are the four clinical types? Subtle, tonic, clonic, myoclonic. So electroencephalographic seizures in these two varieties, one is epileptic, another variety is non-epileptic. So epileptic, if you take, consistently associated with electroparticle seizure activity on the EEG. Means in epilepsy, epileptic variety, whenever you take an EEG, always there will be electroparticle seizure activity in the brain. Cannot be provoked by tactile stimulation. It is always present. It will not require any attention. It is always present. That is why it is called epileptic. It cannot be suppressed by restraint of involved limb or repositioning of infant. We cannot stop it. Related to hypersynchronous discharge of a critical mass of neuron, some focus is there in the brain where it is initiated. So it is related to hypersynchronous discharges of critical mass of neurons. Okay. So if you take non-epileptic, there is no electroparticle signature. Means electroparticle, if you take an EEG, there are no epileptic EEG pattern. But if you provoke by stimulation like light or sound sometimes, then it will be provoked and then we can get this electrocortical activity. It is suppressed by restraint or repositioning the infant. And it can also occur as brainstem release phenomena, that is reflex activity. What are the seizure mimics? This is an important question for you in final year exam. Can occur, they can ask what are the important seizure mimics. Okay, seizure mimics in newborn include jitteriness. Jitteriness means it may be due to multiple reasons. It is oscillatory movements across the joint. Okay, it may be due to hypothermia, hypoglycemia or hypocalcemia. All these conditions can lead to jitteriness. Apnea has many other reasons, but seizure can occur as apnea in case of subtle seizures, but sometimes may not be associated with seizures. That is why it is called a seizure mimic. Benign neonatal sleep myoclonus. It looks like seizure, but it is not seizure. Benign neonatal sleep myoclonus, someone might ask you. So remember that seizure mimics are jitteriness, apnea, benign neonatal sleep myoclonus. Apnea. In epileptic form, apnea lasts for less than 10 to 20 seconds. Tachycardia may be associated and it is always monorhythmic. In non-epileptic form, more than 10 to 20 seconds is the apnea period and it is associated with bradycardia, no EEG signs. So benign neonatal sleep myoclonus, non-epileptic form of myoclonus. This is non-epileptic, no epilepsy, no seizures. It occurs usually in the first week of life. It resolves spontaneously over weeks or months. And there is a transient dismaturity of brainstem reticular activating system. Okay, this is due to transient dismaturity of brainstem reticular activating system. RAS, reticular activating system. Movements abolished by arousal. Whenever the newborn or infant arises from sleep, it is immediately lost. There is no myoclonus. Never occur in awake state. It will not occur. Whenever the neonate is falling asleep or coming out of sleep, only this type of benign neonatal myoclonus will occur. Otherwise, there is no seizures in this kid. Progress is excellent and 100% of them will be out, okay, out of this condition. no EEG findings will be there. If you take an electroencephalography, there is no EEG findings. So neonatal seizures, what are the important etiologies? It is critical to recognize neonatal seizures. Why we have to recognize neonatal seizures is to determine their etiology, because if you know the cause only, we can treat them properly. So identify the cause. So seizures are usually related to significant illness, sometimes require specific therapy. So majority of the time seizures is associated with some underlying condition, serious condition. So we have to recognize it to give specific therapy. Maybe it is a infection or meningitis or some intracranial hemorrhage or some intracranial mass. Okay, all these conditions. So neonatal seizures may interfere with important supportive measures such as alimentation, means feeding, and assisted respirations for associated disorders. And experimental data gives some reason for concern that under certain circumstances, the seizure per se may be a cause of brain injury. So control seizures, the surrounding brain tissue can get damaged. Clinical history, always ask clinical history. But how do you ask? When it started exactly? What is the progression? What is the type of seizure? Semiology of seizure means how did it start? How did it progress? Which limbs are involved? And how the baby is? How much period it lasted? What are the associated symptoms and signs during that seizure activity? What how it get recognized? All these things include involves clinical history. Family history is important because it may suggest some genetic syndromes also. Epileptic infantile epilepsy syndromes will be there. So family history is always important in this condition. We should ask any child or adult in the family is having seizures. Many of these syndromes are benign. Okay. In the absence of other etiologies, family history of seizures may suggest good prognosis. So pregnancy history is important because during pregnancy, mother may get some torch infections. You know already what is torch. So torch infections which may lead to brain damage by CMV or some other toxoplasmosis, all these cause brain damage. You already know that. So history of fetal distress means hypoxemia or asphyxia in the fetus. Preeclampsia or maternal infection. Preeclampsia due to decreased placental circulation and maternal or maternal infections. All these conditions may predispose to seizures. And delivery history, because when during delivery, if the delivery is not timely and it is delayed, or any birth injury occurs during delivery. So delivery history is very important. And type of delivery, normal vaginal delivery or lower segment caesarean section, what is the reason, meconium aspiration, all these things is important. And antecedent events, like antecedent events in the sense, like if you take an antenatal fetal surveillance with this fetal Doppler and all, any abnormalities are there, we have to always see and correlate with this. Apgar score. Apgar score offers some guidance. Apgar scores, you already know now. What is Apgar score? See here. Jyoti Prakash. Hello.
Sir.
Apgar score ante telusa ledha?
Hello sir. Ah sir. Telusu.
Ledha.
Hello sir.
Apgar score telusa ledha?
Telusu.
ఓకే ఓకే సో లో అప్గార్ తెలియదా తెలుసా
తెలుసు సార్
ఓకే రైట్ సో లో అప్గార్ స్కోర్ without resuscitation and subsequent neonatal intensive care is unlikely to be associated with neonatal seizures. Okay, so Apgar score is in the first 5 minutes, if the Apgar score is very less, that is less than 3, then the outcome will be definitely bad. What is the maximum Apgar score? CR? What is the maximum Apgar score?
Nine, sir.
Kaadu, 10. It's a maximum of 5 into 2, 5 components. Maximum score is 2 for each component. 5 into 2, 10. Okay. In the immediate newborn birth, so it will be usually 9 because color, the central or peripheral cyanosis is not gone. So usually maximum 9 will be there, but the score is 10. Out of 10, 9, it is very good. So postnatal history. Postnatal history. Whether baby is having any hypoglycemia, baby is refusing to feed, or baby is having any sepsis, or any hypocalcemic seizures, hypoparathyroidism, or any metabolic disorders, inborn errors of metabolism, all these causes. Neonatal seizures in infant without any uneventful antenatal history and delivery may result from postnatal cause. Tremulousness may be secondary to drug withdrawal or hypocalcemia. Temperature and blood pressure instability may suggest infection. In the first 24 hours of life, the usual causes are HAE, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, CNS and intrauterine infections, sepsis, drug withdrawal, vascular causes, birth trauma, pyridoxin dependency, inadvertent local administration of anesthetic into the head, scalp. Okay, so that causes toxicity and seizures. From 24 hours of life to 72 hours of life, the common causes are cerebral dysgenesis, means improper formation of brain. Okay, abnormal brain development, cerebral dysgenesis, vascular causes, metabolic causes, urea cycle disorder, drug withdrawal. Okay. Maternal drug withdrawal, pyridoxin dependency, incontinentia pigmentae, tuberous sclerosis. From 72 hours to first week of life, familial neonatal seizures like some sleep, myoclonic epilepsy, all these things, familial neonatal seizures can be there. Cerebral malformations, cerebral infarction, hypoparathyroidism leading to hypocalcemia. Vascular events like venous thrombosis, hemorrhage, kernic trust, that is bilirubin encephalopathy, aciduria's, methylmalonic aciduria, propionic acidemia, urea cycle disorder. So inborn errors of metabolism are more common. Tuberous sclerosis. Benign familial neonatal seizures are like their autosomal dominant type of seizures. No obvious risk factors are identified. Second or third day of life, they occur, recur for days or weeks. During the time of seizure, if you take ictal EEG means during time of seizure, there will be sudden brief period of generalized voltage attenuation on EEG. The clinical features are apnea, tachycardia, and tonic portion. Generally, no anti-epileptic treatments are required. It will subside on its own. Benign idiopathic neonatal seizures. Normal neonatal course. There will be normal neonatal course. Birth after 39 weeks of gestation. Seizures usually occur on day 4 to 6. Normal neurological state and function. Clinical clonic posturing might be there, but normal EEG. This also is normal and it will recover. Okay. Transient these are. So how do you evaluate a seizure that occurred in the newborn period? How do you want to evaluate? First of all, immediate treatable causes we should always identify. So first, always immediately what you should do is whenever there is seizure for more than 3 minutes period, immediately we should position the baby under a radiant warmer, then clear if any secretions are there, start on oxygen airway, and circulation part we should take care of and connect it to ECG as well as saturation monitor and immediately check, insert a cannula and check blood glucose. First blood glucose, this is a treatable cause. If you have sugar levels are low, we can immediately give dextrose and correct it. And we should always check for electrolytes also, immediate correction of these things. And calcium we should send, and blood urea nitrogen. And complete blood count and differential count to rule out infection. Platelet count to for any intracranial hemorrhages, maybe possibility. Urine analysis should be done for any ketone bodies in the urine. And blood oxygen and acid base analysis for inborn errors of metabolism, these are required. Blood and CSF analysis and bacterial cultures are required to rule out sepsis. CSF analysis is very important in case of pyridoxine dependency seizures and sepsis, meningitis. Okay, and EEG is always important. Some EEG are classical of some syndromes, so we should always do an EEG. EEG seizure, repetitive series of electrical discharges that evolve in frequency and amplitude. Okay, EEG seizure is repeated series of electrical discharges that evolves in frequency and amplitude. What is a normal rhythmic EEG pattern? It is age specific. We cannot compare an adult EEG from a newborn EEG because the newborn brain myelination is not yet completed. So you cannot compare an adult to a newborn EEG. EEG seizure is less common before 34 weeks. EEG seizure, because less than 34 weeks, myelination will not occur at all. So there is no, we cannot get an EEG seizure. Frequency increases with increasing maturity. Remember, and for evaluation of neonatal seizures, if we don't get in the initial studies we have done already, we should go to some other studies like serum immunoglobulin levels, torch antibody titers to rule out torch infections, and viral cultures rarely, like herpes simplex virus. Just blood, no one is doing viral cultures. Blood and urine metabolic studies, bilirubin, ammonia, lactate, ferric chloride, reducing substance, all this for inborn errors of metabolism. Blood and urine toxic screens should be done because some sort of toxemia due to some external agents, we should always rule out. Blood and urine ammonia and organic acid screen, CT or ultrasound scan is required. CT and ultrasound sometimes is for brain, any intracranial hemorrhages, intraventricular hemorrhages to be ruled out. Okay. Treatment. First, treatment depends upon the cause. So identify the cause first, then only you can treat. If it is hypoglycemia, give dextrose D10. If it is hypocalcemia, give calcium gluconate. Hypomagnesemia, give magnesium sulfate. Pyridoxine deficiency, give pyridoxine. Meningitis, we have to initiate antibiotic. Why you have to treat is to minimize the brain damage. Otherwise, subsequent neurodevelopment outcome will be bad. Some controversy when to start anticonvulsants is always there. If seizure is prolonged for more than 3 minutes, subfrequent or associated with cardiorespiratory distress, we should always initiate anticonvulsants. So commonly used drugs. What are the commonly used drugs? 40, rule number 40. Anticonvulsants. What? Pharmacology అయ్యిందిగా ఫార్మకాలజీ అయ్యింది కదా
సోడియం వాల్ప్రేట్
ఓకే ఇంకోటి చెప్పు
ఫెనోబార్బిటాజెపామ్
benzodiazepines, okay.
Phenytoin,
okay.
Carbamazepine,
okay. Gamma. Levetiracetam, అర్థమా లేదా? విన్నారా లెవెట్రో సెటమ్? సో ఇన్ ద న్యూ బోర్న్ పీరియడ్ ద కామన్ అండ్ ఎక్స్టెన్సివ్లీ స్టడీడ్ యాంటీ కన్వల్సెంట్ ఇస్ వాట్? What anticonvulsant is commonly used in the neonatal period?
Diazepam.
Phenobarbital, sir.
Phenobarbital, very good, very good. Phenobarbital is the commonly used because baby brain is having this phenobarbital receptors. What is the pump? Some pump will be there. 2-chloride channel will be there. Is extremely responsive. So drugs are phenobarbital, phenytoin, benzodiazepines like diazepam, metazolam and lorazepam. Usually we will not use carbamazepine or sodium valproate in units. Nowadays they are using levetiracetam as a other third line drug. Okay, so phenobarbital at 20 milligram per kg, maximum to 40 milligram per kg we should give, and followed by maintenance doses. Usual adverse effects are hypertension, respiratory depression and arrhythmias can occur with phenobarbital. Therapeutic level is in the blood is 15 to 30 microgram. Phenytoin is, the dose is similar to phenobarbital, 15 to 20 mg per kg, but infusion rate should not cross more than 1 milligram per kg per minute. It should be less than 1 milligram per kg per minute. Maintenance dose we have to give every 12th hourly at 4 to 8 milligram per kg per day. Adverse effects are cardiac toxicity will be there, arrhythmias chance, and cardiovascular collapse can occur, hypotension. Therapeutic level is 10 to 20 microgram per ml. Administration as infusion does not mix with, this is the only anticonvulsant we should not mix with dextrose. We should give in saline only. Understood? Benzodiazepines, but at least in someone of you identify the cause why we should not mix in dextrose and message in the group. Seventh semester is there, no, pediatric? Okay, at least type in that. Benzodiazepines, diazepam, no one is using now because the chances of hypertension, cardiovascular collapse, cardiac arrest is high. Narrow therapeutic index, and sodium benzoate is used as preservative, which can itself cause some problems. Midazolam is fast acting, also cause apnea, cardiac arrest and respiratory arrest. Lorazepam is has having longer duration of action with wider therapeutic index, so safety level is good and less chance of respiratory depression. Understood? The dose is 0.05 to 0.1 mg per kg stat follow. We can repeat the dose for 3 times. Acute therapy of seizure, neonatal seizures. If with the hypoglycemia, glucose 10% we should give 2 ml per kg IV. If no hypoglycemia, start with phenobarbital 20 milligram per kg IV loading dose. If necessary, addition to phenobarbital, we can go with phenytoin also and lorazepam also if required in subsequent. So immediately, this is the flow chart. Neonate with seizures, identify and characterize the seizure. Secure the airway, always airway is important. Airway breathing and circulation are very important, including temperature. So start if seizures are continuous, because while seizures, airway may get compromised and oxygen may not go to the brain. So always we should start oxygen to avoid hypoxemia. Hypoxemia is even more dangerous. So secure IV access and take samples for baseline investigation. We already discussed sugar, calcium, magnesium, sodium. Okay. So potassium, arterial blood gas, hematocrit, and sepsis screen should be done. If hypoglycemia is there, we should always, we already discussed, we should give 10% dextrose. If hypocalcemia is there, 2 ml per kg of calcium gluconate we should give. brief history and quick clinical examination we have to do. If seizure still persisting, start phenobarbitone over 30 minutes or 20 minutes we should give. Still seizures continuing, repeat phenobarbitone 10 milligram per kg per dose till a total of 40 milligram per kg. Still seizures are continuing, start phenobarbitone 20 milligram per kg per dose. Still seizures are continuing, repeat phenobarbitone 10 milligram per kg per dose. If seizures stop with all these, we should always go ahead and do a CSF study, ultrasound head and EEG. CSF study for meningitis, ultrasound head for any mass in the brain or intracranial hemorrhage, EEG for epileptic form discharges. Still with these medication also seizures continue, consider lorazepam, metoprolol, bolus or infusion. Consider ventilation, ventilate the newborn because there is high chance of airway compromise. Still seizures are continuing, we should always look for pyridoxine deficiency and add pyridoxine. Exchange transfusion may be required for some cases and seizure control can occur. Okay, CSF study, CT, MRI, EEG, metabolic workup for inborn errors of metabolism should be considered when it is not controlled with usual antibiotics. And what are the determinants of duration of anticonvulsant therapy for neonatal seizures? We should always see neonatal neurological examination, cause of neonatal seizure, and EEG, electroencephalogram. Okay, these three things decides the etiology. Neonatal neurological examination and EEG, these three decides the duration of anticonvulsant therapy. When to do an EEG? As soon as seizure occurs, within 24 hours is very good. Continuous EEG monitoring is very good. Intraectal EEG may be normal sometimes, and EEG abnormal, video EEG monitoring may be required. Repeat EEG at 1 week duration is also required. Duration of anticonvulsant therapy in the neonatal period, if normal neonatal examination, the neurological examination, discontinue therapy. If neonatal neurological examination is persistently abnormal, consider the etiology and obtain EEG. In most cases, continue phenobarbital, discontinue phenobarbital and reevaluate in 1 month duration. So 1 month after discharge, if neurological examination became normal, discontinue phenobarbital gradually, tapering doses. If neurological examination is persistently abnormal, obtain EEG again, take EEG again. If no seizure activity on EEG, definitely discontinue and taper and stop phenobarbital. So this is the tapering. Newborn on anticonvulsant therapy, wean all antiepileptics except phenobarbital once seizure is controlled. Perform a neurological examination prior to discharge. If it is normal, stop phenobarbital also prior to discharge. If it is abnormal, continue phenobarbital for 1 month duration. Repeat neurological examination at 1 month. If it is normal, taper the drugs over 2 weeks. If it is still abnormal, neurological examination at 1 month. Take an EEG. If EEG is normal, taper the drugs over 2 weeks. If it is abnormal, continue the drug and reassess at 3 months of age. Okay. So prognosis. So you should always say the parents that how the seizures are going to continue or stop, because seizures in a newborn are is a very anxious. Parents will become anxious, worried about their baby's condition. So you should always say about the prognosis. So two most useful approaches in utilizing outcome is EEG and recognition of underlying neurological disease. So depending upon EEG, the prognosis is, if EEG background is normal, neurological sequelae is less than or equal to 10%. Severe EEG abnormalities, then more than or equal to 90% will have neurological sequelae. If the background is having moderate abnormalities, approximately 50% may have neurological sequelae. Common causes and outcomes. The best outcome is with late onset hypocalcemia. 100% they will be neurologically normal in late onset hypocalcemia. If you say on hypocalcemia late onset, 100% they will be fine. And benign familial neonatal convulsion, 100% they will be fine. Fifth day fits, they are also 100% benign sleep myoclonus, 100% fine. And next subarachnoid hemorrhage also 90% they will be fine. HAE 50% may be normal, 50% abnormal. IVH 10% may be normal. Hypoglycemia 50-50. When bacterial meningitis 50-50. Okay. What are the complications of seizures? Neurodevelopmental abnormalities like cerebral palsy can occur. Hydrocephalus. Epilepsy means subsequently they will have continuous seizures. Spasticity means there will be contracture development and tightness in the limbs. Physiotherapy is required for this. Feeding difficulties will be there. Consultation, neurology consultation needed for evaluation of seizure. Evaluation of EEG and video EEG monitoring are required. Management of anticonvulsant medication. Outpatient care, how will you follow? Development evaluation for early identification of physical and cognitive deficits. Orthopedic evaluation if joint abnormality due to spasticity, if joint abnormalities occurs. Orthopedic consultation is required. Consider physical medicine, that is physiotherapy. Refer referral if indicated for exercises to prevent contractures. Thank you. Attendance Ichara Babu. Ujjikamalu. Ichara. అరే ఇది కూడా చెప్పడానికి నోరు నొప్పారా ఇచ్చారా లేదా
చాట్ బాక్స్ లో పెట్టేశారు సార్ అందరు
ఓకే రైట్ వెళ్ళండి వెళ్ళండి